Okay, welcome back to this rotameter working. So we discussed in that last lecture. So upthrust force will be there due to that buoyancy flotation, and gravity force will be there due to that whenever flow is going to be decreased. So why? Because of these two things, and one more thing will be there, weight of that ball means that is that tube, weight of the float also we can consider over here. So now we will see that one more picture of that. Here we are clearly we are going to seeing that equilibrium and float movement, flow also we are going to seeing in this measurement flow rate. Generally the flow rate we are going to measured with the calibrated scale, and reading we are going to noting. And from end point to that, and cap of that tube will be there. So generally the rotameter for each application we are going to using different sizes of the floats. So when the sized correctly, the flow rate can be determined by the matching of the float and the position to be calibrated. As per that I am showing that figure, as per that one it will be like that. Okay, and position to be calibrated from that outside rotameter with the help of scale. So here many rotameters are there are many rotameters are available with that built as in that valve type and adjustment flow as manually. So several shapes are available in various applications. Whenever early design of this floats, the design will be that head slots will be there, and it is going to be caused for that float to spin for stabilizing and centering purposes. Stabilizing and centering purposes we are going to using because of this type of float we are going to using rotated floats. And the term of rotameter means it is going to be coined, means it is going to be rotated. So generally this rotameters we are going to providing for calibration data purpose and direct reading of the scale for air as well as water. We can measure it air also, we can measure it how much velocity of the air also we are going to measuring it. So the size of the rotameter we are going to design depend upon the flow of velocity of flow of flow will be there. According to that we are going to selecting this rotameters. Generally we are going to standard flow only, we are going to selecting all these types of floats. So generally water standard flow is that water we consider it, and it is going to be equivalent liter per minute, liters per minute we are LPM we are going to shortly calling as liter per minute. For gases standard flow is that air flow equivalent to standard what is that unit is that cubic meter per hour, cubic meter per hour, meter cube per hour, meter cube per hour we are going to measuring that air flow or gas flow we are going to taking. Generally standard water is equivalent to LPM by tables we are going to considering, and air is cubic meter per hour, and we are going to providing for rotameter different type of rotameters manufacturer side and manufacturers. And we are going to using this rotameters to provide slide rules. Slide rules means scales we are going to providing slide rules, and monographs we are going to providing, and even though we are going to attaching this rotameter computer software also. Okay, sizing. So generally we are going to finding out the volumetric rate of flow through that flow through that rotameter is given by that Q is equal to AW into C under root of 2GVF into rho F minus rho W divided by AF by rho W. This is that equation, the volumetric flow rate of the through that rotameter. From this equation, we are going to finding out how much volume is going to be passed through that tube. We are going to finding out with this formula. So another the pressure difference also we are going to finding out. That pressure difference delta P we are going to using Vf is equal to rho F minus P into G by AF. So with the help of these two equations we can find out what is that volumetric rate flow. So here one of that, what is the Vf? Vf is that volume of the fluid or float, volume of the float. Aw is that area of the annual orifice, that is equal to pi by 4 into d plus b y whole square minus d square, where the d is the diameter of the tube. Then when the float is going to be zero position, d is that maximum diameter of the float, y is that height of that float above the zero position. Whenever we are going to measuring, that zero position should be there. Okay, and b is the change in the tube diameter per unit change height. Okay, AF is the area of the float, we know that, and C is that discharge coefficient, and G is that acceleration due to gravity. G is that acceleration due to gravity. Okay, acceleration due to gravity, and rho W is that liquid density, and rho F is that float density. So AF, AF is that area of the tube, AW is that area of the annual orifice. Okay, with this two formulas we can finding out volume flow rate of through that rotameter. We can see that graphs also. In this graphs we can see that from Reynolds number we can use that up to 20,000. So over there we are seeing this graph, rotameter will be that, float shape will be there. This float shape we can take it whenever the flow is high. Okay, this is this graph's coefficient of discharge versus the Reynolds number. Okay, it will touch maximum one coefficient of discharge. So another you can take coefficient of discharge is 0.5. Then that rotameter is that shape will be that half shape will be there. Over there we can find out A, B, C, we are given different shapes. According to that we can select shape of that rotameter. Okay. The range of the repeatability and accuracy. And what are the advantages? There is no need of external power. Okay, one thing. So there is no power required, either direct current or AC current. Manufactured with cheap materials. Yes, we can manufacture. I told that manufacturing brass we can use. We can use steel. We can use plastic. We can use aluminium. Okay, all these things we can use this rotameter. The generally the area of the passage increases as the float moves up in the due to the up thrust, and the scale is approximately linear. Okay, where linearization we are going to considering over here. So it is a wide rangeability, 5:1 to 12:1 we can use that, and high repeatability 0.5 to 1%, low accuracy. And as well as we are having disadvantage, when advantages will be there, automatically disadvantages will be there. What is that disadvantages? Impact of gravity, accuracy of the rotameter, all these things will come under picture of this rotameter. So in that rotameter, one more subject is there, that is that we are having one more flow meter, that is the turbine flow meter. In this turbine flow meter, it is as like of rotameter. So it is construction also same. We are going to using this turbine flow meter to measure the water flow in the river and streams. So turbine flow meter. The rotary speed of the turbine flow meter is generally depends upon that flow rate of the fluid. Flow rate of the fluid. How much flow velocity will be there? How much flow force will be there? We are going to using same like that of rotameter. Generally, the speed can be measured turbine blades. Whenever a turbine is going to be rotating, so then we are going to how much flow is going in the river, that water is going outside from the banks. From the banks over here. Sorry for that one. So now, over by feeding of these pulses, means pulse means it is going and it is touching to the turbine blades, that is called as pulses, to an electronic pulse rate meter we are arranged over there, downside of the flow meter, and we can measure that rate and accumulate that total number of pulses during that trimmed interval, and the total flow we can obtainable. So this flow meters, this type of flow meters we are going to using for rivers. Another one more flow meter, orifice meter. That orifice meter will be there for flow through nozzles will be there. This flow through nozzles will be there. Whenever this nozzle we are going to keeping in that flow over there, the flow is coming, the nozzle is going to be with that high pressure and high velocity of liquid is going to be released out. From the nozzle, then we are going to measuring that flow of fluid. So here we can see that this flow of fluid, different plates will be there. One is that orifice plate will be there, ASME flow nozzle will be there, standard venturi will be there, and long form venturi will be there, and low loss venturi will be there. All these things to be connected with this meter. Okay. This generally this meter also we can convert into that venturi meter. This venturi meters we are going to available in the size of 1800 mm, and it can pass that 25 to 50% of more flow. Okay, that more flow will be there. And it should not be exceed 10% of the measured dimensional pressure. That is that one of the considering thing. It should not be more than that 10%. It should not be crossed. Okay. The generally the short form of venturi is that entrance angle will be there, and due to that entrance angle, the increased annual chambers. And it is going to be replaced by that taps. Okay, this is that working principle of rotameter, and advantages, disadvantages, and graphs, and how to calculate that flow we measure, we seen. Okay, thank you. We will see that in the next class.